Chances are, as you add more and more information to your SmartSuite solutions, you're gonna start to feel a little overwhelmed. You've got a lot of data in a tight place, and it's hard to get all the important stuff on the screen that you need at once. Well, thankfully, SmartSuite has a plan for this. They have created sections inside of the record detail page that allow you to cultivate what happens when you expand your record. These sections were built with simplicity in mind, and you will see that as we walk through this example, because we are going to make it so easy for ourselves to organize our information and only see the stuff we want when we open up that record. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. SmartSuite is at the forefront of these no-code tools, and I'm excited to jump in today and go step by step into how you can use the record sections inside of the record detail when you expand a record. But before we get into the heart of it, I first want to invite you to join me to follow along inside of your SmartSuite account. Simply open up SmartSuite and go step by step with me as I demonstrate this particular feature. And if you don't already have SmartSuite, please use our affiliate link below so that you can get set up. Number one, it gives some love back to the channel. And number two, you will be eligible for some exclusive SmartSuite swag if and when you choose to upgrade in the future. So if you do choose to upgrade to a SmartSuite account, be sure not to miss out on your swag by using our link below. Now that being said, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen, and we already have a solution built inside of SmartSuite. Here I am in an invoice application. Now of course, records live inside of an application, so when we talk about the record detail page, it is gonna be specific to an application. So in this case, I'm in invoices for my side hustle solution, and I've got a bunch of different records here. Now, when I'm dealing with the record detail page, it only comes into existence, or it's only shown on our screen when we open the record. There's a couple of ways that we can open a record. Number one, we can just click right here where we have that up and down arrow, and it's going to expand the record. Alternatively, you'll see that when we hover over here, it also gives us a little pro tip that says when your cursor is hovered over a row, simply press the space bar to open a record. So let's go ahead and try it. Here I am testing my own record, and I'm hovered over there, I hit space bar on my keyboard, and voila, I have the expanded vision of that record. But you'll see that this is looking a little unorganized, right? I have the title of the record, which is a generated title. It's taking invoice for, and then I've got the contact name sent on, this information here, and then I have the amount. Doesn't really relate to the name of the record per se. I have the date created. Lower on down, I have the file itself. I have the date paid. I have the status. It's kind of a mess. All this information is just really strewn about all over the place. So how can I get things more organized so that when I open up this record, I can see what I want to see, and it's a little bit more cohesive? Because honestly, this is just a lot of noise, and it's just a random assortment of data. Well, that's where sections are going to come into play. So as a workspace administrator, as a creator of this solution, I have the capability of this more advanced feature. So wherever you see these three dots, when I hover over a particular field, I can click on that action menu, and I have the option then to come on down here and add a section. It is the section that's going to make everything much more organized. But before we get into it, let's talk about the different sections we might want to make for this particular application. So obviously we have some similar data that might be well suited for getting it grouped together in sections. For example, if we leave over here and we go back out, we have some contact related information. We obviously link to a pipeline deal, but then we also have the contact. We're also looking up the email address. And this is all associated with the actual deal that we're closing and contact information. Then we also track stuff about the invoice itself. So what's the status of that invoice? When was it paid? Also, when was it created? And then we have just the general invoice information, like the amount and the name or the ID of this particular invoice. And then of course the invoice file itself. So those might be three distinct sections where we want to organize the information just into those groups. So let's get started. Now, first and foremost, we can get started with the contact related information. So we had the pipeline deal kind of leading the pack there. So I click on the action menu for this one and I add a section. Now by default, this is called untitled section. So I'm going to come over here to the menu and rename the section. And once it's highlighted, I can then name it to be, let's say, contact information. And hit enter to leave that renaming modal. And now I've got this particular section and I can just collapse it. And you see that everything underneath here is just automatically collapsing. Now, obviously we don't want all of this information to be in this particular section. So let's break something out into another section, maybe the invoice details. So we can actually grab the file itself and just go ahead and add a section, and we'll call this invoice details. Again, this time I didn't click out of the section when I first created it, so I could just rename it right from the get-go, and I hit enter to leave that modal. So now if I collapse this, everything underneath here is getting collapsed as well. Now, of course, it makes more sense that this lookup email gets reorganized and added up above with the contact information. So when I hover over this particular field, you'll see that I've got the six dots over here that I can just click and drag and move this up into another section. Now when I collapse my contact information section, it's just collapsing the information in this little section. And then down here, I've got my invoice details. And of course, I also want to break out my dates and bring them into yet another section. So we'll do that here with date paid, add a section, and I'll have this just call it dates, for example. And we can choose to either keep the invoice status in here, or I might choose to move it into the invoice details itself. And just as easily as that, we can reorganize all of this information inside of our record. And so all I'm doing, again, I'm not impacting the actual record information itself. I'm just creating my own way of looking at that information and moving the information around so that it gets into the right section of my record. So let's drop the title in here. Let's go back, grab the date created, bring it on down into the date section of this particular record. And then lastly, we'll grab that amount and drop this into the invoice details as well. So now that I have things more or less organized, I might want to actually reorder the sections as well. Maybe I want the invoice details to be up at the very top. So in order to do that, all I do is I click on that section and I tell it I want it to move up. So there we go. I've got invoice details at the very top. Underneath that, my contact information section. And then lastly, the different dates that might be associated with the information in this record, both the date created and the date paid. But that's not all. I can also choose to automatically collapse these by default. Maybe the dates aren't that interesting, and by default, I don't need to see them when I expand a record. Heck, maybe even that's true for the contact information. All I really want to see when I expand a record on an invoice is the invoice details, and I generally don't care about contact information or dates. Well, in that case, all I have to do is go to that section, again, click on the menu, and say that I want to collapse this by default. Now, that does not mean that this particular section is not able to be opened. It is still going to be visible to people who have the appropriate permissions. Of course, if you don't have permission to view any of the information here, you won't see anything if you expand that section. But assuming that we do have access to these two different sections and the information that lies inside of them, once we have decided that we're going to collapse that section by default, and we save this all up, well, when we open up a record, what do you think we're going to see? Well, in this case, we're just going to see those invoice details. Of course, those other sections do live here, and if I need to drill into this for any reason, I can. I can look at the contact information, I can expand into the dates and see the date-related information, but by default, that is not going to show up for me when I expand that record. This is going to help you save so much time and just stay way more organized when you're expanding your records. Imagine if you did this for every single application so that you only saw the information you cared about when you opened it up. Now, one final question you might have is, does this expanded record view impact all of my different views? Well, let's test it out. Let's go ahead and close down this record and actually just create a new view. I'm going to create a new timeline view from scratch, let's say. And the curious thing that we're looking for is, if I expand a record, does it hold the same format? And you see that, in fact, yes, it does. Here it is, my invoice details still up top, my contact information, my dates, my different sections collapsed by default with the appropriate information inside of them. So So all you have to worry about is building the expanded record view one time per application, and those rules are going to carry throughout all the different views that you create within that application. This topic is going to help you save so much time, so I hope you got a ton of value from it. If you did, be sure to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on future no-code news and no-code consulting. And in the meantime, keep on building.